Two teams that know each other well. We'll see the St. Louis Cardinals taking on the Cincinnati Reds in Cincinnati, Great American Ballpark, live here on 2K Sports.
We'll see one of the game's bright young stars. Is there a bigger name in the game right now than Joey Votto? Well, he's going to try and sustain that name in this game today. The St. Louis Cardinals and the Cincinnati Reds, two teams from the National League Central, they go at it here in Cincinnati. Glad you could be with us, 2K Sports Major League Baseball. We've got Matt Latos, he's the starting pitcher. And as he gets going against these St. Louis hitters, what do you think's in store?
Well, you can see a young pitcher, Matt Latos, with great presence on the mound. He seems very calm out there, like he's experienced everything before. When he doesn't let emotions come into play, he's at his best.
Here's the lineup for the Cardinals. Scouting pick, John, who are we looking at today?
Well, there's not a lot of areas in Matt Holliday's swing that you can beat him on as far as a pitcher goes. You better pitch careful to him. You better hope that he's in one of those moods where he decides he wants to chase pitches out of the zone, because if he doesn't and you have to throw strikes, you're in trouble.
Punch him out.
The pitch. Ball. Cause for concern, but nobody on here. One delivery, a fastball taken for a strike, 1-2.
Oh, Gary, he's got such an effective fastball. He likes to use it. And, you know, 1-2 count, he doesn't like to mess around. Look for him to go right at him with the heater.
The 1-2 pitch. Oh, he lost control of that one, and that gets him.
I don't think this was the game plan when they sat down before the game even started. First batter takes his base by getting hit with a pitch.
We got a chance to check out the Reds here. Let's look at their defense.
A solid defensive team right here, especially within this division. They're the best. The fewest number of errors committed of anybody in the division, and it really does separate them defensively from all the other clubs.
And the question after you've hit a batter like we've seen here, Steve, is as a pitcher getting your focus back.
Yeah, but listen, it's only one runner on. Take a deep breath, get yourself back and settle down a little bit and make sure you're right.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch. Here's the pitch. Swung on by Bergman. He hammers it. And gone. Goodbye. The homer and the Cardinals getting on the board with a long ball. And so they jump out to the 2-0 lead. Wow, what a great time for a two-run shot like that. Let's take a look at the change in the win expectancy brought on by that two RBI homer.
A great piece of hitting right there. He turns on that one, rotates the hips, and drives the ball.
And that's going to give them the lead here and an early lead.
I'm going to see if they can tack on a few more here in the first and put the pressure on.
Fastball called. Strike three, and the side is retired. The lineup Dusty Baker's put together for this ballgame. John, who do we keep an eye on?
Joey Votto is a run-producing machine. There's just no other way to put it. Tough to strike him out. Exciting left-handed hitter with great opposite field power.
Now the St. Louis Cardinals will look defensively. John, scouting anyone here?
Yeah, the weapon. I mean, Yadier Molina. There's no better catcher in the game defensively than Yadier Molina. Not only does he keep runners close at first base because he can throw behind the hitter and pick them off at first base, he blocks balls better than anyone. To me, if you're going to build a catcher and a model catcher, Yadier Molina is that guy.
Garcia gets set and delivers. This is pop foul to the right side, but playable. And Berkman pulls it in. Two away.
He takes charge and puts it away.
And it's Joey Votto now. He's got a .295 career batting average off the Cardinals. Oh, that runs inside and gets him.
You'll take one for the team, but sometimes it's going to leave a mark, and that's definitely going to. The fastball can hurt.
Scott Rowland, he'll get... Fastball swung out and missed, struck him out, one away.
Let's take another
look. For the Reds at home, still translated into just a 42-39 home. Now here's a grounder towards the hole. The slide, and he is in there, safe. Good offensive chance here. Pitcher, especially with that top of the order waiting. Here it comes, and he tries to get one down. Hannigan. And he throws to first in time, out number two.
Look where he placed that one right there. Take a look at it. Perfectly placed.
He is out at first, but the damage was done around the bases. Those runners,
second best in the National League, only behind the Philadelphia Phillies.
Swung on. That is labeled by Ludwig. And goodbye, the home run for the Reds. They are on the board. They trim a bit off that deficit with that solo homer, coming to within one. Steve, that one's right where power hitters love it, high enough to drive.
Up in the zone and right in the wheelhouse, and I tell you what, they don't miss those pitches.
Foul ground last time around. Here we go. Here's the first pitch. Big swing, straightaway center. Warning track. Wall looking up. Oh, Jay, nice play. And a good defensive half inning. Three up, three down. And David Freese misses. That is strike three.
Way in the strike zone, and if they look for it and get it, they can really...
Big swing and a drive, deep left center field, going back to the wall, and he drops back to the warning track to pull it in. Three up, three down for Jaime Garcia. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Swung on, grounded towards the hole. And out number one as he steps on the base.
Two strikes, you just have to battle and battle and battle and hope he gets one down in the zone. You can just drop the head of the bat on.
Well, he was able to ring up that. Lados with a delivery.
You're out.
And he can't pull the trigger. Beltran strikes out.
You know, what I like about this is on 0-2, he didn't mess around. He didn't try to nibble to get him.
Pitch on the way towards the middle. He caught it. Oh! That was headed right for the pitcher. Good, quick reaction. He got it.
Pitchers are taught once they release the ball, they become a fielder. He was in good position right there to be able.
There's a swing and a ground ball. Gets it. There's one. Back to first. Not in time. One and two won't get it. For Kyle misses, he's gone.
Well, two strikes on the hitter, and he came inside. He just couldn't catch up quickly enough to it. He must have been thinking away.
Slider swung on and missed, struck him out. That's going to retire the side. So, no runs, two hits, and they strand two. Still tied up here in Cincinnati. It'll be the leadoff man trying to get things going here.
That's what he did, but he got the slider and he swung through it, but a big, powerful swing.
And Ryan Ludwig swings right through that one. Strike three. And doing the pitching is going to be Aroldis Chapman. They've decided it was time to make a change here.
Well, this was an outstanding performance today. I mean, that's good starting pitching right there. He won't be able to finish what he started, but he pitched a heck of a ball game.
Oh, and he takes off for second. And he is out trying to take second. He got him. Good pitch to throw on, Steve.
Well, he had the fastball, and it was set up in the right spot. He had a quick release to gun down the runner.
Fastball in there. Struck him out. Out number two.
You talk about a guy with full command of his pitches. Only four of them, but he located and executed them perfectly.
And as a result, this game stays.
Try to throw it out of the zone and get him to chase.
Got him. So now they'll have their chance to win this thing with a run in the bottom half. It's the kind of inning the defense likes. Three up, three down. Tie game here in Cincinnati.
Better to go after the fastball when a guy has quality secondary pitches. Even though it's down in the zone, you've got to swing at that.
Oh, he's going to try to make the play. One away. He deals. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Great stop. Diving Phillips. And he's out at first. What an out. Diving stop and a nice throw, too.
I showed great range on that one. I didn't think he had any chance to get it, but he able to get it and get on his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Tremendous job.
And we've got Cruz batting. He stands. Ah, Freeze is stealing. And his throw, he is out. Great throw. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Still tied up, Cincinnati.
Ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
Fastball got him, two down.
Now we're going to get a chance, Gary's young hitter with pop in his bat.
Bottom half, extra inning, game on the line. Let's see what we get for a swing here.
Boy, you played this long, it would be tough for either side to lose. Let's see how it plays out.
First pitch was a strike, 0-1 now.
Well, climbing the ladder on him right there. He just throws that fast.
He swings. A high drive. Straightaway center. This could be it. Going, going. Goodbye, home run. A game-winning shot. It's off the wall on a hop.
Walk-off win for the home team, getting it done in extraordinary fashion. Everybody celebrating.
Well, it's that time again. How about we take a look at our player of the game? Terrific pitching from Matt Latta.
Well, you know, Gary, he got touched for a couple runs, but that doesn't overshadow how great he was in this game. Anytime you can go that deep in the game and only give up those two runs and you can turn it over your bullpen, it's a manager's dream. And he delivered that performance today, and that's why his team got the big win.
And, Steve, that ought to send these folks home happy.
Oh, no question about it. They get the win in a close game, a lot of excitement and enthusiasm, and ready for the next one.
And that's going to do it for us here. For Steve Phillips, John Kruk, I'm Gary Thorne. Take care.